And I guess the final thing, I was just thinking of this too. I like to make my video short. The other thing with the FRQ and the test is what they consider to be Unit 6 in AP Micro and what they consider to be Unit 6 in AP Macro will not be included on the test. So it makes also makes me sad. It's tough. There's a couple tough things. I know econ dorks, we love our econ. And Unit 6 in Micro is, of all the units, my favorite one. Of all 12 units that I teach in AP Micro, AP Macro, that is definitely my favorite one, because that's where we look at, how and why the government intervenes and when it's a good thing and when it's not a good thing. And I just think that has so many implications for how to understand. I mean, that's what we're seeing right now. We're trying to understand how the government is going to intervene on this huge, health and economic crisis that's going on right now. And so if you look at the lives, at least what I'm seeing right now, Unit 6, all this stuff on government intervention, none of that stuff you're gonna have to worry about for the test. But what they're saying is, they're saying, well, even though you don't have to worry about it for the test, it's something that you would need to know, or you would want to know going into college. But if you're just taking the class to get a credit and you're not going to do anything beyond econ, I mean, it's just kind of their way of saying, try to look at it, maybe, please. So if you think, because you're there, if you're like a biology major, you're not really gonna, I mean, it actually would. That's a lot of the stuff that you would see in class. It's unfortunate they had to cut something out, but they decided to cut something out, which is a good thing because it makes it a lot easier. So we don't have to worry about anything with government intervention. Thinking back to macro, what was our Unit 6? What was it? It was foreign exchange. That stinks too, because that was like probably our best unit. That was the one that you guys got going. But I guess it's one less thing to worry about. You know what? You know what the how they're gonna set up the macro FRQ. The macro FRQ is in all likely is gonna be, you're gonna be in a recessionary gap or an inflationary gap and fix it. And then with the micro, it's gonna be, here's, I'm assuming it's gonna be a monopoly or a perfectly competitive market. My prediction already is gonna be the FRQ is gonna be a monopoly, and then it hires out of a monopsony, or a perfectly competitive product market hiring out of a perfect competitive labor market, which is what you're going to study in April. And then they'll just ask a bunch of questions with justification. That basically, I think, is what that will be my prediction for now, and that could change when I find out more information. But like I said, we don't have to worry about Unit 6. They are cutting a little bit of that off the test, and how that's going to look is anybody's guess, because they've never obviously done this before. So that'll be kind of one of the things that I want to do, is think about how to best prepare you. I imagine what we're going to do, assuming if we are not back in May, which who knows, but if we're not back in May, I'll run some YouTube lives, or maybe some Zooms where we can do some review sessions the week before the test to get you ready, and really making sure we can draw those graphs, we understand those graphs, we can explain things, talking through. I'll probably make like the five key graphs, and then for each class, and then the five key things you might have to explain, hoping that that gets you ready for whatever it is they're going to throw out the FRQ. So yeah, hopefully, we'll be prepared. I don't put hopefully on that. We will be prepared. But those are just some things to think about. So hopefully everyone's doing well, and email me if you have any questions. So rock and roll.